Hello dear students, today we are going to read one of the most important topic of English grammar, and the topic is verb. And this topic is really very very important, because if you want to learn English then you can't move further without studying this topic. So let us start. First of all, let me tell you what is verb. What action take place or what is done by a person or thing is verb. Like Maya pants, one action is there, so it is verb. Next, what a noun is, it is also a verb. Like he is a teacher, this is also verb. What our perception of a noun is, it means what do we think about a noun. Like suppose I say the child appears to be all right, so appear is a verb here. So what are verbs? Verb means action. What a noun is, or what are our perceptions about a noun. Let us move on further. We can classify verbs into two parts, helping verbs and main verbs. Helping verbs are needed to form the grammatical structure of a sentence. Primary helping verbs are form of the verbs like be, do and have. These verbs can be used as helping verbs and main verbs also. Let us see some examples. Aditya is writing an essay. In this sentence, is the helping verb and writing is the main verb. One more sentence, Aslam is the head boy of the school. In this sentence, is not the helping verb, it is the main verb, because in this sentence only one verb is there, so it should be the main verb. Next sentence, does Mr. Rao teach English? So in this, does is helping verb and teach is main verb. One more sentence, I do my homework at night. In this sentence, do is main verb. I hope you understood the difference between main verb and helping verb. Now, usage of do, we can use do to make negatives like I do not like coffee. We can also use do to ask questions like do you want some food, and we can also use do to show some kind of emphasis or pressure like I do study for my exams. Okay, now let us talk about be. We use be to make continuous tenses like is, am, are, was and were. Like the sentence is, Raj is watching TV at home. Shabnam was waiting for you at the bus stop. We can also use be forms to make passive. Like the fruits are kept in the basket. The thief was caught. Now let us read about have. We use have to make perfect tense. It means we can use has, have and had. I have finished my assignment. One more, he had made a promise. So we can use these to make perfect tenses. Now let us read about regular and irregular verbs. First we will read about regular verbs. Verbs that form their past tense form and past participle by adding d or ed are regular verbs. Like one example is there, I work in Bengaluru, that is present tense. I worked in Chennai for 2 years ago, it is past tense. I have worked in Bengaluru for the past 2 years, that is past participle. So these are the forms how we are making using d or ed. So these are regular verbs. Now, irregular verbs form their past tense and past participle in many different ways. There is no fixed pattern to make the past tense and past participle of irregular verbs. There are three types of irregular verb. First one, verbs with all the three forms identical. The best form, the past tense and the past participle. We can see the example here, like cut, let, bet, bid, broadcast, burst, cast, cost, forecast, hit. heart, input, these all have same forms. Some more are there: put, quit, read, set, shut, slit, spread, upset, wed, wet, shed. These also have the same forms. Verbs with two parts identical like these verbs can be either regular like ed using after learn or irregular also with using a suffix t. Let us see the examples like spend, spent, spent, come, came, come, build, built, built. Same with burn, dwell, learn, smell, spell, spill, spoil. Remember dear friends, these verbs, they can take two forms as past tense and past participle. Both are right. Beat, have, hear, lay, light, make, pay, remake, say, sit, slide, spit, understand, withstand. These are also like that. Now, verbs with all three parts different. Like go, went, gone, blow, blew, blown, speak, spoke, spoken, do, did, done, draw, drew, drawn, eat, ate, eaten, begin, 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 drink, drink, drunk, ring, ring, run, shrink, shrink, shrunk, sing, sing, sung, sink, sank, sunk, spring, spring, sprung, stink, stank, stunk, swim, swam, swum, arise, arose, arisen, drive, drove, driven, ride, rode, ridden, rise, rose, risen, stride, strode, strode, or striden, ride, rode, written. So you have to take care of these things.